what does the employment law say concerning this that's happening with the NPF right now?
Oh, well, thank you very much, Udoka. You remember that last week we dealt with Project Restart for the English Premier League, the propriety of the decision of the Premier League to issue disclaimers to most of the players, more or less exempting them from some of the statutory liabilities that would have ordinarily inured in favor of the players. Now, we also examined the Employment Rights Act, the Unfair Contract Terms Act, and everything. Now, we don't have comparable statutes here in Nigeria. But what the law has done is that through the influence of the common law and you know, case law principles and all that, the law has been able to imply some of these rights even when they are not expressly provided by statute. Now, Chapter 2 of the Constitution provides for a number of the economic rights of employees. Parts of these rights include right to work, right to be given work, right to wages, right to a safe working condition, right to conditions of work, service, and everything. Now, when you look at all these rights, of course, Chapter 2 is not justiciable, so ordinarily, they will not be able to bring any action under Chapter 2. But then you remember that Section 7, Sub 6 of National Industrial Court Act, more or less, enjoins the National Industrial Court to recognize international treaties and conventions ratified by Nigeria, and in interpreting them to apply international best labor practices. So now the construction is such that when such matters come up before the courts will definitely look at the competing rights of both the employer and the employees. Now for the employee, for football, from a footballing perspective, you would look at the issue of the duty of trust and confidence, which is a mutual obligation between the clubs and the players. Now, this mutual duty of trust and confidence presupposes that both parties should treat each other respectfully, and the players and employees should not be subjected to undignifying terms of work or service. So you are bringing the players back to work. What safety protocols have you put in place? Now, we've seen what has happened in the Bundesliga. We've seen what is about to happen with the English Premier League. Even with all the health infrastructure in the English Premier League, a lot of the players are still skeptical about coming back to play so soon. Now, you come down to Nigeria where we don't have comparable health infrastructure. We don't even have safety measures in place. So are you going to play behind closed doors? I was expecting that in issuing its communique, the NFF would have been able to issue some sort of draft protocol. That would have resonated with the government when you are pitching the issue of restarting the league to the government. Now, you have not done that. You are jumping the gun. You are telling the league that, oh, that when the government gives the green light, that players can go back to work. Now, we also dealt with the issue of collective bargaining agreement. What is the role of the players? I know we don't have players union, even if it's there's one in existence in the league. It's either comatose or is not even living up to its responsibilities. Now, what have you done? Have you engaged the players union to actually have their thoughts on this proposal? So these are the things that agitate my mind, and I look back and I fear because you don't even have good insurance policies that can cover these players when they contract the disease, or even in the event of any other eventuality. That has not happened. You want to put the players' lives on the line. Now, it is also instructive to mention that players also have the right against unfair dismissal. That also applies both from a footballing perspective and general employment law. So the players, if some of them refuse to come back and the clubs now tow the path of probably issuing or starting disciplinary proceedings against some of these players and even terminating their contracts, they might have a claim for wrongful termination or constructive dismissal. So that is the instructive point that we all should bear in mind. So it bothers me that we are doing this without putting the necessary things in place before doing that. Because are you going to shut down the stadia? Are you going to make sure that people don't find their way inside the stadium to go and watch these games. What are you going to put in place? We saw in the Premiership what is being proposed. You can't even celebrate your goals.
Yeah.
A goal celebration should be hushed. You're not expected to start jumping on top of each other to celebrate goals.
Yeah.
You're not expected to... all the players get tested before every match, and they get tested every day at training. So are we putting all these things in place with a country that is struggling to even test 25,000 of its population in the whole country?
I think most of the problems in Nigerian football is grossly institutional. Institutional in the sense that, by the way, the league is 30 years. And for 30 years, we've not been able to get a good sponsor for the league. For 30 years, we've not been able to put health institutions in the league to provide safety for players in terms of injuries and all. For 30 years, there's still issues of football hooliganism. We still remember the case of Igenewari George when he was playing for Bendel Insurance. So these are huge concerns. So going forward, like you've said, we've always had issues with restarting our league. And a lot of times we keep postponing the resumption date. And it doesn't allow the football world take us serious. And you know it affects when the transfer season opens, it affects when it closes, it affects the domestic transfer market matching system. And these are the institutional issues. We believe that after 30 years, the Nigerian Professional Football League should have taken care of these issues. So even issues of wages, players' contract. So the league as it is right now, for me, needs a total overhaul. If I am an investor, I cannot put a cent of my money in an Nigerian Professional Football League the way it is being run. Because one, there's no transparency, there is no statistics, data. How do you put money into that kind of situation? I'm a businessman, I put my money where my mouth is. And if I'm a businessman, I can't put my money in a situation where the league is almost opaque. So these are issues the NFA and maybe the MPFL, should a league management company, should deal with decisively so as to bring the glamour and the beauty we were known for back in the days. But as it is now, I'm sorry to say that it's a long way to El Dorado.